It's very important to the process of understanding Google Cloud and passing the certification exam that you go through the question and attempt answering it yourself first. So pause the video, work through the question. We'll catch up in just a little while and I'll show you how I do it. This project scenario is based on the TerramEarth case study. Today, TerramEarth maintenance workers receive interactive performance graphs for the last 24 hours, or 86,400 events, by plugging their maintenance tablets into the vehicle. The support group wants support technicians to view this data remotely to help troubleshoot problems. You want to minimize the latency of graph loads. How should you provide this functionality? So in this project scenario, we have got these vehicles coming in to some service center. The support technician plugs in a tablet that they have into the vehicle. And data that has been collecting in the vehicle for the last 24 hours, which amounts to an event per second, is all pulled out and loaded to the central server. Now, the support technicians would really like to use this data now to compare it with probably what happened in the previous days to see if some maintenance needs to be done on this vehicle, or are they expecting something to happen that they want to preempt. The support group wants to give this ability to the support technicians to view this data quickly. What is the problem right now? The data is probably centralized somewhere, and because of this, the graph loads or the data loading is taking an inordinately long amount of time, which they would like to minimize now. Let's look at what are the options we have to solve this. The first option suggests that we execute queries against the data stored in a Cloud SQL. This is possible. The fact that Cloud SQL supports, say, MySQL, Postgres, and MS SQL, we can run queries against them and get the data. Now, looking at the TerramEarth case study, there are a few things that we should recall. TerramEarth collects a total of about 9 terabytes a day from these connected vehicles. So this is clearly big data scale. We are collecting almost about, say, 365 into round off to about 10 terabytes a day, about 3,650 terabytes of data a year, or about 3 petabytes a year from all these connected vehicles. So there's a large amount of data that they're trying to process. The next thing is that these service centers are in around 100 countries. So clearly they're not located in some region, say like Southeast Asia or the US West Coast. These are spread all across the world. The question now for Cloud SQL is that, will it scale to this kind of data requirement, which is in many petabytes, and will it serve a global audience? Cloud SQL, say for example, taking MySQL as an example, does not scale beyond a few terabytes. Right? It can go up to tens of terabytes, but it is unable to support, say, petabytes of data well. Therefore, Cloud SQL is not looking like a good option for the kind of or the scale of data that we are going to need. Cloud SQL is also regional. You typically choose a region and then have maybe backups in another region, but your single source of truth where you're going to be writing data is going to be in one location, in one region. Therefore, the requirement that we support over 100 countries is not going to work for us using Cloud SQL. So both on scaling and global audience reach, Cloud SQL is not going to be effective. Therefore, we can eliminate option A. How about option B? Option B suggests that we execute queries on data in BigTable. Now, queries in BigTable are not going to be SQL, but they are queries nevertheless. So I think this part is okay, that we can query the BigTable database. The next suggestion is that in this, we need to have the data indexed by vehicleid.timestamp. Okay, let's see how that works. In BigTable, when we have data, we define a key that allows us to easily access that data. So typically, this could be a combination of different columns. Say, for example, vehicle ID and timestamp would be one of it. When a technician wants to look at the data for a vehicle, it then becomes very easy to just use a single vehicle ID for just the data that he wants to look at for this vehicle. The fact that we've also appended a timestamp allows us to look at this data in a particular period. So we can say we want the data for, say, vehicle ID 123 from last 24 hours up to the current moment. Or it can be from the last 7 days up to the current moment. And that can be taken as a timestamp. So when we have data in this key format, it allows us to quickly narrow down this large amount of data. So far, this option is looking good. The next thing we need to consider is that when this vehicle is brought in, somebody's plugging in a tablet into it, pulling out all the data that collected over the last 24 hours and uploading it immediately to a backend server. So there's going to be a large amount of writes that are going to happen. Does BigTable support a large number of writes and very efficiently? The answer is that it does. BigTable is able to scale very well for both read and write to many petabytes of data. So we have not only the ability to write this data very quickly, we also have a very fast way of reading it back. Therefore, this is starting to look very good for us because we're able to get a large amount of data in quickly, we're able to minimize the latency of the graph, and BigTable also allows you to scale globally by increasing the number of nodes in different regions. We can add new clusters in other places or in other regions and locations, which means that the data that is accessed locally is going to have very low latency. So considering all of these factors, we can be fairly sure that this is looking to be a very good answer. But of course, we can't immediately decide. We have to see whether the other options have any better recommended practices that would be preferable. As of now, let's just keep this as a possibility and move on to the next option. Option C suggests that we query BigQuery tables. Now, querying BigQuery tables is going to be very fast. It is able to work with analytics data at very, very large scales, and BigQuery is also optimized for reads. So querying BigTable to minimize the latency graph would be a great option. Let us now look whether the remaining requirements are also suited by BigQuery. In the case of BigQuery here, we are suggesting that we make these daily partition tables. This is fairly good because we just have to now look at the data that has come in, say, over a certain few days. So if we wanted to just see the data for today, it is very easy to see now because that data has been partitioned to just today's data. We can probably have data from the last three partitions, which would be the last 3 days or last 7 days as we require. So this is also looking to be a fairly good option right now that we have a limited view of all the data via these partitions. One thing we do not have though is that this data is not partitioned by vehicle at this point. So there's going to be data coming in from multiple vehicles and they're all going to be inside the BigQuery database. But we will have to run some kind of scan on the data to pick up data for just one particular vehicle. So this is going to increase the time a little bit and is going to fail us a little bit on the minimizing the latency. The next consideration would be writing all this data very quickly. So when the vehicle comes in, we need to load this data via the tablet, which means that we want a large amount of writes to happen quickly and that should be efficient. However, BigQuery is not optimized for writes. Therefore, writes via BigQuery are not going to be too efficient, and this is starting to weaken now. We also have a problem that BigQuery is primarily based in a region. or you can also choose it to be a multi-region, but it is not truly global in the sense that some of the reads from certain countries are probably going to have to travel to a different continent to be served. So given that it does not scale extremely well to a global audience, we also have the problem of serving this with low latency all across the world. Given a few of these weak points, we would rather eliminate option C because we already had a better option in option B. How about the last option, D? We start off with the same idea that we have queries running against BigQuery, which, like we said, is a possibility. BigQuery is going to be fast for reads. It's a great analytical and OLAP database. So that part is okay. But the rest of it, like we saw, that the fact it does not scale very well for writes and that it is not truly global means that it's a bad option already. Without even considering the excessive points in cloud storage and BigQuery Federation, which is not going to help in any way, it is only going to hinder the speed, we can say that option D will not be suitable for us either. Given all of that, option B, to use Cloud BigTable and to query data in it via the vehicle ID.timestamp key, is going to be the best of the options we have in this question. Now, it's time to subscribe to all the great content we've got lined up for you to learn Google Cloud and to help you with the certifications.